Good morning, students. This is Harshnath Shukla, and I am going to take class for class 12, and this is revision class. So topic is relation and function. Topic is relation and function. So in this topic, first of all, we are going to study the cross product of two sets, that is product of two sets. So first of all, let A and B are two non-empty set, then the product of these two sets is denoted by A cross B and is defined as A cross B is equal to A comma B, such that for each A belongs to A and B belongs to A. B belongs to B. So this is the product of two sets. Okay. So what is ordered pair? If we take A with the product of A with A, then this is A B type element for each A B belongs to A. This is the ordered pair. So what is relation? If we understand the product of two sets, then easily we understand the relation. So relation is nothing but relation R is a relation from A to B, then R is nothing but a subset of A cross B, nothing but a subset of A cross B. That means a relation is nothing but a relation R is, a relation R from A to B is a subset of A cross B. Okay. Suppose A is equal to 1, 2, B is equal to A, B, then A cross B is nothing but 1A, 1B, 2A, 2B, then any of the subset of A cross B that is supposed to be 1A, 2A, so this is the relation. Now we are going to define relation on a set A. So relation on a set A means the relation R is the subset of A cross A. So please see relation on a set A. Relation on a set A. Relation on a set A. Relation on a set A means relation R is subset of A cross A. So suppose A is equal to 1, 2, then what is the value of A cross C? You know, 1, 1, 1, 2, 2, 1, 2, 2. So any of the subset of this, that is 1, 1, 2, 1, 2, 2, this is the relation. Okay? And this is nothing but relation on a set A.
Okay.
So this whole about the relation, which you already had in class 11, so you already studied about this. Now you are going to proceed equivalence relation. We are going to proceed to equivalence relation. So what is equivalence relation? A relation R from a set A, R on a set A is known as, is said to be an equivalence relation if it is first reflexive, second symmetric, and third transitive. So before understanding equivalence relation, we need to understand reflexive relation, symmetric relation, and transitive relation. So first we are going to see reflexive relation. So what is reflexive relation? Let reflexive relation, let R is a relation on set A, let R is a relation on a set A, then it is said to be reflexive relation if for each A belongs to A, is R related to A. That is, A belongs to R for each A belongs to A. A belongs to R for each A belongs to R for each A belongs to A. So this is reflexive relation. Please note it down. Now, symmetric relation. Okay. Now, symmetric relation. Symmetric relation. Let R is a relation on a set A, then R is said to be symmetric relation if for each AB belongs to A, is R related to B implies B is R related to A. That is, for each AB belongs to R, A comma B belongs to, each AB belongs to A, A comma B belongs to R, implies B comma A belongs to R. Okay, so this is the symmetric relation. Please note it down. This is the symmetric relation. So now third one is the transitive relation. Okay, third one is the transitive relation. So transitive relation, transitive relation. Transitive relation. Let R is a relation on set R on a set A, then R is said to be a transitive relation if a transitive relation if for each ABC belongs to A, A's are related to B and B's are related to C implies A's are related to C. That is, for each ABC belongs to R, A comma B belongs to R and B comma C belongs to R, this implies A comma C belongs to R. So this is the transitive relation. So in this manner we understand the equivalence relation. So what is an equivalence relation? A relation which is reflexive, symmetric and transitive is known as an equivalence relation. Now we are doing some question based on equivalence relation. So first question is, let us consider, first question is, let us consider delta 1, delta 2 and delta 3 are triangles in a space, in triangles in a plane which are congruent to each other. Which are congruent to each other. Is this relation is an equivalence relation? So my question is this relation is an equivalence relation? So please check it out. Let delta 1 is congruent to delta 2, delta 2 congruent to delta 3, delta 3 congruent to delta 1. So these all triangles are congruent to each other. So first one is reflexivity. We have to check reflexivity of this particular relation. So you know very well, delta 1 is congruent to delta 1, that is delta 1 is R related to delta 1. Why? A triangle is congruent to itself. Okay. Now the symmetricity, if you want to check, delta 1 is R related to delta 2 implies delta 2 is R related to delta 1. Why? If a triangle is congruent to another triangle, then the second triangle must be congruent to the first triangle. Okay. The third one is the symmetricity. Third one is the symmetricity. Sorry, transitivity. So in transitive relation, transitivity, delta 1 is congruent to delta 1, 2, that is delta 1 is R related to delta 2. and delta 2 is r related to delta 3, and this implies delta 1 is r related to delta 3. Why? Because by the geometry you know very well, delta 1 is congruent to delta 2 and delta 2 is congruent to delta 3. This implies delta 1 is congruent to delta 3. Okay, delta means triangle 1 is congruent to triangle 2, and triangle 2 is congruent to triangle 3, and triangle 1 must be congruent to triangle 3. So by the geometry we have to prove this one, that this particular relation is an equivalence relation. Now the second question we are just going to take, these all questions are given in NCERT, so please try to read out NCERT book and understand the problem. Okay, next one is, suppose we have given three lines L1, question number 2, suppose we have given three lines L1, L2 and L3, okay, in a plane. The condition is L1 is parallel to L2, L2 is parallel to L3, L3 is parallel to L1. That is, they are parallel to each other. The relation is what? Parallelism. So they are parallel to each other. So my question is that, is this particular relation is an equivalence relation? So please try to check out. This particular relation is what? An equivalence relation. So first of all, we check it out. Let first one condition, reflexivity. So in reflexivity, let us, L1 is R related to L1. Yes. L1 must be parallel to L1. By the geometry, a line must be parallel to itself. A line must be parallel to itself. So reflexivity is checked. Second one, symmetricity. Symmetricity, that is symmetric relation. So if L1 is R related to L2, then it implies L1 must be related to, L2 must be related to L1. Why? By the geometry, L1 is parallel to L2 implies L2 is parallel to L1. That means if a line, given line is parallel to other line, then the first, second line must be parallel to the first line. It is by the geometry. Okay? So in this manner, we have to prove reflexivity for this particular relation, symmetricity for that particular relation, and now transitivity of for the relation. Now we are going to see, is the relation is transitive or not. Transitivity. Okay. So transitivity means, for each L1, that is L1 is R related to L2 and L2 is R related to L3, and this implies L1 is R related to L3. That means if L1 is parallel to L2, L2 is parallel to L3, and this implies L1 is parallel to L3. This is also by Euclid geometry. You know very well, if a given line is parallel to another line, L1, L2, if L1 parallel to L2, L3, L2 parallel to L3, then L1 must be parallel to L3. So in this manner, we have to complete our topic, equivalence relation. This is a revision exercise. So please try to solve some more questions based on this. Lecture 2 you will get soon. So thank you for today, and I hope you all are safe and good. So please try to solve more and more questions based on this particular exercise. Thank you.